neutral side action, and we're just about set to kick off. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Aguayo is lined up and just about ready to send this one off as we're ready to get this game underway. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
From their own 29-yard line. Second down. Down around the 30-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. Third down.
Mike five. Mike five. Let's go defense. Let's go defense. Run. Run.
Scrambling around. He's to the 40. And down he goes, right around the 46-yard line.
I'm telling you, quarterbacks who can run the ball are so hard to stop. You have to scheme around them, which takes the best coverages out of your defensive playbook.
First and 10, ball on the 46.
Mike five, Mike five. Ready, red, eight.
Tackle made, that's the 44. The running back gets two on the carry.
You're not gonna be able to get by a sure tackler like this linebacker too often.
Sacked.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
They'll line it up again on third down. They bring him down.
Wow, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday now.
Fourth and long here after the sack. Piper is the punter. Wayne fields it at the 19. He's knocked out of bounds at the 27. Florida State's offensive staff, they really build things around this guy, and they know that they can be confident in what he can do all game long.
Yeah, I think they trust in all of his abilities. And the big thing also is he avoids those silly mental mistakes. He does not line up in the wrong position. He's not going to turn the wrong way. More importantly, he's not going to miss out on a blitz on pass protection. So he's really just a total package, very consistent, very reliable running back that this team utilizes.
From their own 23-yard line, second down. Cook takes it up the middle, and he's level at the 22.
Massive run on the play.
He guns it to the left. It's complete. And he's taken down at the 37.
This is a great pitch and catch combination, and they hook up here for a big time game.
Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play.
Down.
is tackled around the 26-yard line.
Well, how about the poise? This kid wasn't worried about the blitz at all. Both middle linebackers were coming, and he stayed calm and delivered the football for a new set of downs.
They'll bring him down right around the 30. From the 30-yard line, it's second down. He's into the open field. Inside the 10. Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal. Seminole saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action. First down. Big opportunity to score here inside the 5. It's first down and goal.
Blue 14.
And they make the stop at the 5.
Loss of 1 yard on the play. That brings up second and goal.
This is the 8th play of this drive. Incomplete.
Probably not the best time to put too much on that pass. They missed a big opportunity right there.
It's third and goal from the 5. Let's see if they can put this one in. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts.
That's a real danger. If he leaves too many passes short like that, sooner or later they're going to end up in the wrong set of hands.
Florida State could take the lead with this field goal. He gets it up, and they tack on 3 points. Aguayo is lined up to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
The Seminoles are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
Throws it in a hurry, and he's tackled at the 32.
That's a gain of 7 on the play. That'll bring up 2nd and 3.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. There's a strike complete. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. Inside the 30. And he's finally shoved out at the 19-yard line. And the big pickup through the air has made it 1st and 10. Down, incomplete.
Anytime you could put the quarterback on the ground, or in this case, bat the ball at the line of scrimmage, you're letting your presence be felt. Believe me, that quarterback is aware of the play of the defensive front.
Gets it out to him again. That's a great tackle at the 18-yard line.
Call it a gain of 1 yard. That'll make it 3rd and 9.
From the 18-yard line, it's 3rd down. He rifles it to the left. He couldn't hang on. Incomplete.
Dunbar was the intended receiver on the play. 4th down.
Houston can tie it up here with this kick. The kick is up, and it's good. They line up to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. Pass complete and taken down immediately. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Fires incomplete.
New walk the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up third and four.
Down. Blue 14. Blue 14.
He's taken down to the 38-yard line.
Well, it was third down, so they obviously had to get to the sticks, and they did just that with this little pass play.
First and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line.
And he just gets rid of it. Is out to the tailback on the screen. Tackle
at about the 39-yard line. And once again, they'll come to the line, try to convert on third down.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man.
Brought down at the 45-yard line. So at the end of one quarter, 3-3 tie. And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. Beatty is waiting for the snap. And here's the... Wait a minute, the upbacks guy. Defense stiffens on fourth down, and the ball will change hands. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime.
Hold this.
Going right to his tailback. Not a bad little play there.
Yeah, this is a nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice gain.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one.
In the open. He's at the 20, and he's shoved out of bounds around the 15-yard line.
And a 20 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
From the 15-yard line, first down.
After a decent pickup.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
Here we go. Mike five.
Ready.
And they got to him before he could get back to the line. From the 10-yard line, third down. Quick strike, and he drops it.
The intended receiver on the play.
Houston is looking to go up by three. It's up, and he's got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 26-yard line. 26 yards.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
Down! Blue 14! Blue 14!
And they push him out at about the 21.
Loss of 5 yards on the play. That'll bring up second and 15.
From their own 21-yard line, second down. They'll spread the field with five wide. Quick throw, incomplete. Wanted his receiver.
Midfield was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it third and 15.
Going long. Oh, he had a shot at the pick.
Boy, Brad, this guy drops an interception. And what's ironic about that from going to the meetings the other day is that this guy's been telling the coaches he wants to play some wide receiver. You wonder why you're not playing wide receiver? Because you can't catch the ball as a defensive back.
They'll bring him down at the 49.
Every single time this offense has the ball, they're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals. And every time they settle for field goals, I've been watching the defense that they've been facing and watching how they run off the field to celebrate a job well done because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
The pitch, and he's got some room. Makes it to the 34. From the 34-yard line, it's first down. Houston has a three-point lead. He scrambles. Diving for extra yardage.
This is a pretty tough guy, and he's a great leader. He's going to do whatever it takes to help his team.
Nice run, and he's brought down. A nice option play. The tailback gets 6 yards before he's brought down. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Up the middle for a nice gain.
Called a gain of 5 yards. First down.
Mike screen. Mike screen. Mike five. Mike five. Ready.
Gets to about the 8 yard line. Second down and 7. Ball on the 8 yard line. Across the middle to his tight end. Tackle made around the 1 yard line.
Yeah, he takes him down. He's got the 1 yard line. That'll bring up 3rd and inches.
I'm coming. Mike five. Ready.
Makes a move and he's in for the touchdown.
This kid is a really reliable weapon. You definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
And he hits the PAT. A 7-play, 51-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. That can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
The score now, 13-3. Cook's struggles here in the first half seem to have also impacted the entire team, and you would expect that, I guess, Herbie. They're really having a difficult time getting anything going now as we head into halftime.
I mean, you hate to put everything on one guy and just put all the pressure on his shoulders. But in this case, it's clear to me that without him leading the way, that this football team is just lost. And I think the coaching staff has got to be concerned. There's still a whole other second half to be played. What kind of adjustments can they make to be able to make some changes here to the results here in this football game in the second half?
Now it's first and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Nice run up the middle. So the quarterback keeps it for about 7 yards.
That'll bring up second and 3.
Got his receiver, dropped it, incomplete.
Wilson, the intended receiver on the play.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Down he goes at the 20. Throws to the receiver, and he's got it again.
Brad, you can really feel and sense the energy coming from the sidelines right now. They know how important it is to pick up first downs, and the coaches right now are showing the excitement that they have and yelling out the next play for the offense. But clearly, the offensive coordinator very happy about the execution on that last play.
That took a little too long to develop.
Yeah, the offense was trying to get the pass rush going upfield, but the defense did a nice job of sniffing out the draw play and hitting them in the backfield.
We've got a second and 11. Ball on the 21-yard line. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Cook picks up about 7 yards on the run.
Third down.
Hey, let's get that ball, D. Let's get that ball. Check, 93's the mic. 93's the mic. Down.
Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Wilson, the intended receiver on the play.
They'll call on the field goal unit here. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. Kicks up, and it is good. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Houston is up by a touchdown. Gets to that quickly. They'll bring him down at the 32-yard line. Oliver picks him up around 7 yards with that catch. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He's scrambling, decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. And he's taken down at the 49-yard line. Houston's going to have to use their second time out of the half.
Ready,
down, and they need to get it down to the 39. Got a receiver, and he dropped it. Dunbar was the intended target, so that'll make it fourth down.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on a pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
Piper to punt.
Not only did that kick prevent a return, but now he's given them almost a full field in front of him. That's a super effort.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He's tackled at the 4. A 2-yard run by the halfback. It's second down. This is a dangerous situation backed up against their goal line. A tight first half of football, and we head to the break. The Cougars with a touchdown lead.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like that it's going to be a great second half. And boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
Well, you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this game. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us. And more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. Just going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here.
Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Play fake. Quick throw, caught by the fullback, and he's immediately tackled.
That'll make it second and seven.
It's second down, seven to go. Ball on the 28. They run it left. Runs it left for a decent game. Let's get out of the field for the official call.
Offside, defense.
Concentration lapse right there. The coaches will be giving them an earful for it, too.
And they make the stop
around the 29-yard line. From their own 29-yard line, third down. Throws complete, he's hit right away. And that was a really well-played series by the defense.
And now they should come away with pretty good field position, so consider that a big stop.
Jackson is back deep to return the punt. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. Jackson takes it at the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. This one might be coming back, folks. Let's check out the penalty.
Clipping. Receiving team.
So they'll move back after that costly penalty, and they'll have to try to get that yardage back here.
First and 10. Ball on the 21-yard line. Houston up 7 points. He's hit and taken down. Close to a 9-yard pickup there on the slam.
You leave your defenders vulnerable when it's man coverage. And that time he paid for being a step behind the receiver.
After positive yardage.
First down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened.
That'll make it second and seven.
Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That makes it third and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down.
Yeah.
first down at about the 49.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. First down.
Zips it to the tailback, incomplete.
Jackson, the intended receiver on the play.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. Fires out quickly to the tailback. And he's tackled at the 48-yard line.
That'll bring up third and eight.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Houston is up a score. He's in trouble.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
The Cougars' running game just took a big hit. Their back went out earlier with that injury, and now they're telling us not going to be able to return today.
Here's the punt. No, they're going to throw it. And he almost has the INT. And so now the ball's turned over on downs. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Makes it out to about the 40.
That makes it first and 10.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 40-yard line. Nice run there. And he picked up almost four on that halfback delay.
That makes it second and 6.
They keep it on the ground with a tailback. He's taken down at the 36-yard line. The running back gets a yard, maybe less. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 30. Zips it to the back. Tackle right around the 24-yard line. He fights forward to about the 23.
That brings up second and 9.
Second and 9 coming up here. Ball on the 23-yard line. A little toss across the middle. And he's stopped behind the line. Tackles him hard at the 31.
Loss of 8 yards on the play. That makes it 4th and 9.
The sack makes this a 4th and very long. It's up, and he got it.
That one looked like cake for this kid. Chalk up 3 points for the offense.
13-9, Houston.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Houston's shown that they can score points. We can see that, but it has not been pretty at all in the third quarter.
Well, they just seem to have gone cold here in the third quarter. And if they can get a big play on defense or special teams, maybe that'll possibly ignite these guys.
Houston is up by 4. Tackle made around the 28-yard line. Second down and 7. Ball on their own 28. Quick release. Tight end. Incomplete.
Oliver was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it 3rd and 7.
They give to the tailback. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line.
Gain of 2 on the play. That'll bring up 4th and 5.
Through 3 quarters now, and still the defenses are shining. 13-9, Houston. Into the 4th quarter now, and we're back to the action. Lane, the return man. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line.
Return for a gain of 14 yards.
Well, this is where stars are born. We're early in the 4th quarter. They're behind, but they've got an opportunity to take the lead. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. 5 wide receivers in the formation. Fires across the middle. That's a great tackle at the 49. From the 49-yard line, first down.
Down. Blue 14. Cut.
And down he goes at the 27. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 26-yard line. And he throws it away. Here's a quick throw. Couldn't haul it in.
Wilson was the intended receiver on the play.
It's 4th down. They're going to try a long field goal here. The kick is up. It's got the distance. And it's good. And he's got to be happy about that kick.
Oh, no question. This kid is just a solid kicker.
So our score, Houston 13, Florida State 12. Florida State is ready to kick it away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Houston with a 1-point lead. First down grab.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
First and 10. Ball on the 36. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
First down.
He's at the 30, and he's taken down right around the 28-yard line.
That makes it 1st and 10.
From the 28-yard line, 1st down. Fires that quickly, incomplete.
That makes it 2nd and 10.
fires out to his receiver. He's tackled at the 25-yard line.
Ramsey makes the tackle at the 25-yard line. Third down.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 18. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He's knocked out of bounds at the 24. Houston is up one. It's up, looks long enough, and he just drilled it from long range. Looks like they're ready for the kick. It's fielded at the 2. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 32. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
The defense got a great push and blew that play up well behind the line of scrimmage.
That'll bring up 2nd and 15.
From their own 27-yard line, it's 2nd down. He's going to try and scramble. Runs with it, and he's got room. And they make the stop at the 45-yard line. And he can't pull it in. From their own 45-yard line, 2nd down. Makes it out to about the 36. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Pulls it in, and that's a 1st down. They'll bring him down at the 25.
That makes it 1st and 10.
1st and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. Oh, and he can't hang on. Huge drop there.
Campbell is the intended receiver on the play. That makes it 2nd and 10.
They come out in a 5-wide set. Makes it out to about the 16.
Gain of 9 on the play. That'll make it 3rd and 1.
Here's the 8th play of the series. After a decent pickup.
Gain of 4 yards. First down.
We have 2 minutes left to play in this game.
Hey, watch number 5. Number 5. Number 5. Hey, D-line, let's get in there.
Touchdown, and that's going to give them the lead. Florida State staff, they've got to love the fact that they've got this kid in this situation week in and week out.
Yeah, I mean, they know that when the chips are on the table, they've got to find a way to be able to get him his touches, and this time he steps up in a big way for the touchdown.
So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. He makes the PAT. A 9-play, 70-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
And it was really those long runs that really helped propel that drive.
So the score now, 19-16.
Boy, this is a competitive game. It's fun to watch these two teams go back and forth. Just when you think one team has the edge, the other gets right back into it. This is exciting.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Less than 2 minutes in the 4th quarter. and he's hit immediately. And he's tackled around the 41-yard line. Now he tries to buy some time. Brought down at the 43-yard line.
Gain of 16 on the play. He makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. The quarterback in the gun with five receivers. He's on the run. Very good tackle in space. Houston's going to use their first time out of the half here.
That makes it second and 6.
Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. Out of bounds, right around the 34.
Third down.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds.
16 yards. First down. Is in at quarterback.
You ain't going nowhere. My five.
Under a minute left.
Green nine.
The Cougars call a timeout. That's their second of the half. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
Pretty good tackle right there by the freshman defensive lineman.
Second and 8 coming up here. Ball on the 16-yard line. Touchdown! And now they're winning this ball game. Late in the fourth quarter now, and with that score, this game's a one-possession ball game, and it's really going to get tense from here on out. And he adds the extra point. Has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Cook's a guy that we've been talking about for 3 hours, Kirk, and now he's in the spotlight.
Yeah, this is an exciting opportunity here in this football game for this offense. You got to think that they're going to find a unique way to get the football into his hands. Now it's just a matter of, can this defense slow him down and stop him?
Right around the 40. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
From their own 40-yard line, it's first down. He goes out of bounds at the 41.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and 9.
Throwing left. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. It's first and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. Under a minute left in the game. And brought down immediately. The Seminoles are going to call their second timeout. Caught out in the open. He's taken down at the 21-yard line. Want it all here and does!
dig deep to score here that late in the fourth quarter and come from behind. And now the question is, can their defense dig in and win it for them? Trying to go up by three, they'll kick the extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. They're lined up to kick, and they might just kick it short and prevent a long return. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. I think the question right now is, who's going to step up defensively?
Well, it's just been so much offense here in this final stand. I just want to see somebody step up and be a leader to try to be able to secure a victory.
This is what you dream about, situations like this. You've got the football, you're behind, but if you take the lead, it could mean a win. He throws it away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Scrambling around. And he can't get away from the pressure. Houston's called their final timeout.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
Just a tremendous job by that defense, and their coordinator did a super job there to keep it this close in this ballgame, and now the offense has got a chance to win it. So this one's final. Very well played by both teams today. 26-23, Seminole.
Houston, 23.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.